Hello everyone and welcome to my YouTube channel, Scale Up SaaS. Today I'm going to show you how you can set up your own Node.js server for free in AWS. It's going to be very interesting and simple to do it. And I also set up for you my GitHub with a GitHub repository with all the instruction and install you need to do, so you don't need to write everything. You just need to follow and listen. Everything is available to you on my GitHub, Scale Up SaaS. So let's start. I'm going to set up a new server, an Ubuntu server, on my AWS account, and I'm going to show you step by step how you can do it too. If you guys don't know how to set up an AWS account, I have another YouTube that I'm describing and showing you how to do it. So please visit. And now we're going to choose the free option of Ubuntu Server 20.04. And of course, we're going to choose the free tier. Great. Here we're not going to touch anything at the moment. We just go with the default setting. And also here we just changed something, the GP volume type. It's also free and it's better than the default one they suggest. And now we're gonna set up our security group. Okay, security group is basically like a firewall for our Ubuntu server, and we're gonna set up in order to make our server secure as much as we can. So first of all, we have the SSH port. I'm gonna make it available only to my IP. I suggest you guys to do that too, so nobody can enter to your server via SSH. And the second port I'm gonna open is port 3000. Basically, it's the default port for Node.js server. And this is how you're setting it. I'm gonna open it for everyone, so everyone can basically see the server. Okay, perfect. And next, we're just gonna launch our server and check that everything okay. But before that, we need to download the key pair, the PAM key. Okay, so we can SSH to our new free Ubuntu server in AWS. Let's download this bad boy and launch our instance. Okay, it's taking like a few seconds. AWS is very fast and very comfortable. I really recommend everybody to do it. So here is our server. We're gonna name it as a Node.js server. It's gonna take like a few seconds for AWS to initialize the server. Okay, perfect. The server is initialized. And now we're gonna go to the connect to show you what the command that you need to run. First of all, we need to set a CH mode for the PAM key we downloaded. Okay, so it's gonna be more private. Otherwise, we won't be able to connect the Ubuntu server that we just launched for our Node.js tutorial. Okay, so I'm changing the permission of the PAM key that we just downloaded, and next we're gonna connect to the server. It's very simple, and like you see, it's less than 5 minutes. SSH, we're gonna put the key name and its location and enter. Let's do yes, and perfect. We launch our first, not first for me, yeah, first for you guys. But we launch our server. Let's check that everything is okay. We're using the htop command. You can see the CPU and the memory. And next, we're gonna go to the GitHub repository of the Node.js server, and we're just gonna follow the command of how to install. The first step, we're gonna install it through NVM. NVM basically, it's a library that helps us to manage our Node.js version, so we can always choose which NVM version we want to run on our server, the latest version, the stable one. With NVM, we have more options than use traditional download option of the Node.js. So I'm just using the wget and downloading the Node.js installation. Next, basically, you can copy paste from the installation output, or you can copy from my GitHub repository. Okay, you don't have to do it. You can disconnect and connect again. But in order for us to be able to use NPM, we need to run those three comments, so it will be available for our Ubuntu user. And now we can see that NPM successfully installed. And here we have the option to install the latest Node.js server version or the stable one, the version 16.0.14. Okay, I'm gonna use the stable one. And that's it, guys. It's like, wow, you saw how fast it is, how simple it is. For me, when I start with it, it was like so complicated. And now I want to share with you how easy it is. Like in less than 10 minutes, you have your own Ubuntu server with Node.js server activated that you can use for your SaaS, for your app, for your project that you have, to show your skill if you are interviewed for job or something like that. And as you can see, we check in all the installation of the Node.js we have with the NPM library, as I told you a few minutes ago. And if you guys want to switch, this is the way that you can switch between a Node.js server. I'm gonna use the most recent stable one. And next, now we are basically setting up our JS file, the Node.js server file. We cd to the folder I created a few minutes ago. You don't have to do it, but just more comfortable to save it in one place. And I'm gonna copy the code we have, the JS code, and I will save it. I will just show you that everything is working, and then we're gonna go and for every line and line. Here I'm just need to change the host name. I'm gonna put here the server IP we just created in AWS. Okay, cool. And let's save the file, Control X and yes. Perfect. And now we have the last command, node app.js, in order to run our server, our Node.js server. And the server is up, is running. Now we're just gonna put our the server IP with the port number, otherwise it's not gonna work. Okay, the default port is 3000. And voila, guys, you set up your first Node.js server in, I think, less than like 10 minutes on free AWS Ubuntu server. So it's accessible for everyone and not just for you guys. Okay, everybody in the world can access your new Node.js server. Okay, so let's go over the code so you will understand what basically we set up. So the first thing, we use the library HTTP, the Node.js HTTP library. And then we set up the host name and the default port, the 3000. Here you can put whatever you want. You can put which port you want. You just need to make sure on AWS it's open. After that, we're setting up the server, create a server with a respond and request variable. We're setting the default HTTP code to 200. And we're setting the header content type HTML in order to send HTML as to our browser. And here we're basically splitting our URL depend on the endpoint of our Node.js server. If I'm gonna put admin, I'm gonna get a specific content. If I'm gonna put something else, I'm gonna get something else. Then you can play with it whatever and however you want. And what will happen if I'm gonna put the address that is not exist? I'm gonna get the page not found because we created the server and we can control the server response with Node.js. So as you can see, it's very simple. The code is very simple. It's simple JavaScript. Everybody can do it if you have a JavaScript as your skill. Next, we're just printing that the server is running, and then we're creating, we're basically activating the server listen option with 0000, so it will be open to everyone. and the port 3000, the default one, but you can choose whatever port you want as long as it is in the limit. Everything is working, and now I'm gonna shut down the server with command C, and voila, there is no server. We didn't did anything. Okay, so in order to run the server, you need to run node space this file name, the file js or the app.js file, and that's it, guys. Everything, as I said, is accessible to you via my GitHub repository. Node.js server, you can do it by yourself. You can leave comments on the YouTube channel. You can ask me questions. Feel free, I'm here for you. If you have not done it yet, please subscribe, share, comment. Let me know what you guys think, because I'm gonna add more and more content and tutorial and video just for you guys.